prime time. I'm zero to end, why bunt down? When I settle in, I break ground. Steal the base when you not around. Go to glove with a triple crown. I raise the ring.
Saturday Night Baseball from Oriole Park here in Baltimore. Tonight, game two of this three-game weekend series between the Tampa Bay Rays and the Baltimore Orioles. Orioles baseball is next. Bruce Zimmerman will be the starter for the O's in this contest. What do we need to know here, Danny?
Hey, one of the things you want to do as a pitcher is eliminate the free passes. Listen, base hits you're going to give up, but you can't walk as many as he did in his last start. He's going to have to pitch much better if he expects a better result in this one.
And now here is Wander Franco. He'll get us started in this one under the lights. Fastball taken, but that gets the zone for a strike. Guys, the Orioles, as they begin play here tonight, fair to say they're not playing their best baseball.
Johnston is now live
five of their last six.
Streaming MLB the Show 2-1, Rays versus Orioles 8-2, 8-2-1.
The dog days of August for a reason. When you're struggling like this team is right now, the games get long, the schedule gets long, and you start looking forward towards the end of the season.
Yeah, but you got to find a way, Dan. You know as well as I do. You got to look in the mirror. You're playing for way more. Especially the way this team is underachieved, you got to keep grinding. You got to find a way, put your foot on the gas, and show up to the yard every day ready to go.
Next, here is Yandy Diaz. First offering on its way.
Ball one, no sight.
Hey, you want to talk about being in the zone? This guy's been raking lately, and it all starts with his pitch selection. Two great takes, and he's almost daring the pitcher just go ahead and challenge him.
Two balls and a strike.
Hey, I still believe in my heart the best pitch is a well-executed fastball down and away, and that's exactly what that is. He swings at that. That's off the end of the bat. That's not hard contact at all, and that's an easy out for the defense.
Here now the 2-2.
Looked to me like he tried to do way too much on that 2-2 pitch. You don't have to come into the zone on that count, but a pitch that far outside isn't going to tempt anyone to swing.
And he lays off here, ball four, and he'll become the game's first base runner here with one away.
He's going to be pretty upset with himself about that 3-2 pitch. All you want to do in that count is make a competitive pitch, but that one wasn't even sniffing the zone, and he let him get away.
Now to bat, Austin Meadows. And there you see the numbers over his last eight contests. He's really been leading the charge for this team. He comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. Now a fastball that couldn't quite find the zone. It's ball one. Meadows, a native of Georgia, is usually a right fielder, but he's playing in left field today. Two balls and no strikes to the Rays left fielder.
He's having a really hard time finding his rhythm and finding the strike zone. It's going to allow this offense to keyhole him in big situations. He's got to figure it out pretty quick.
And look out, as that one ran in and got him. And stepping in, Brandon Lau. Great chance to drive in a run here in the early going. And now the first pitch.
1-0.
Diaz over at second. Meadows is over at first with one away. Swing and a drive to right. There it goes. Into the flag court and gone. So it's a three-run shot to straightaway right field. Home run number 42 on the season as the Rays have opened up a 3-0 lead.
Yeah, he's looked pretty shaky from the first pitch, and things just kind of spiraled out of control from there. I think these guys smelled blood in the water, and they punctuated with a three-run job and an early lead.
Here's Randy Arozarena. As he will look at a first pitch fastball for ball one. He enters play with an even 50 RBIs to this point. Oh, and that ball's absolutely crushed down the line. Forget about it. That's going to stay fair and make it back-to-back home runs. So a solo shot down the line in left, number 28 on the season, and the Rays have opened it up even further now. It's 4-0.
Well, it's very early, but he's looked out of sorts from the beginning. They've already roughed him up for two homers, and they're not done yet. We'll see if he can regroup or he blows up. Could go either way at this point.
Here's Nelson Cruz now. As the changeup to him drops in there for the first strike.
He definitely doesn't look himself to start this one, and this lineup needs to be on the attack early and be aggressive and find a way to stay in this game.
Gets the fastball by him here, and he's in control 0-2.
It's not easy to get your barrel to a pitch that high. That could be an effective location as long as he keeps it above the letters.
Chopped weakly to the left. He's ready. Here's the 0-2 pitch. Not a bad pitch there with two strikes, but it misses 1-2. Four runs here in this half inning. And he got him. Now to the plate. Here is G-Man Choi. He's fighting to stay on that AL home run leaderboard as he finds himself ranked number 10 in the league entering play here today.
You know, D-Row, we're into the summer right now. This guy's power's been off the charts. Looks like he's going to be able to do this all season long.
I think he is, Dan, and the ball's going to start flying now. Weather's starting to warm up in certain parts of the country. We're getting into the middle, late part of summer. You're going to see some epic home runs down the stretch.
The 1-1 is a fastball swung on and missed.
1-2.
There's a fastball well off the plate for a ball.
Hey, they tried to tie him up on that last pitch, so I like that they went away with this one. The execution didn't work, but I like the idea behind it.
And it's fouled away. Bases are empty here with two men out. Grounded up the first baseline, but a foul ball as it holds it 2-2. And they're working the outer half here, but that one's wide for ball three.
Hey, this guy's a hard guy to put away. He's fouling off some tough pitches. 2-2 count, and he just seems to keep hanging right in there.
And he rolls over this one foul. We'll do it once more. 3-2. Another full count pitch home. And he looks at one that misses, and that's an excellent job of making his man throw a lot of pitches as he toughs out a walk.
What's the saying? When you find yourself in a hole, the first thing you should do is stop digging. Well, the guy on the bump obviously hasn't heard that one.
Next up is Francisco Mejia. He represents the eighth man to bat here in the first with four runs already on the board. And he'll try to crowd him there to start the at-bat. It's 1-0.
I think this inning could have far-reaching effects in this game. They're really making him work, and unless he dials it in, it's probably going to limit how deep he goes into this game.
He's out. Throw on to second for the force, and the side is retired. So four runs in the inning, and they come on the strength of the two big flies. On now to the bottom of inning number one, Rays 4, the Orioles coming up. You're watching. Brendan McKay gets the ball for the Rays in this one. Dan Plesac, what's the word on it?
Hey, it wasn't a great performance in his last start, but he did pitch well enough to earn the win. We'll see if he can turn in a little bit better performance in this one.
And now, Jumai Jones. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Now here it comes. Jumai. Sent on the ground out to second. It's flagged down deep in the hole. Throw in time at first. A nice play in short right for the first down.
The center fielder, Austin. Hey.
Now at the plate, Austin Hayes. Ready to deliver. Here comes the first pitch. That's in there, and he's deep in the hole now, 0-2. Time to check our umpires in this one. Behind the plate is Freddie Ferguson.
Hey, D-Row, you better be ready to swing, particularly at that low pitch. Freddie Ferguson, low ball umpire.
Yeah, makes it tough on the offense. I was a guy who liked the low ball, but that usually means those guys are susceptible to that slider in the dirt. You have to see the ball up, and this guy doesn't give you a chance.
Next will be the designated hitter, Ryan Mountcastle. And he's hoping to get things going at the plate. It's been a bit of a struggle for him in recent games. Dan Dero, we take a look at the Rays entering play here tonight. They're definitely in a nice stretch as they've won 6 of their last 7 ball games.
Yeah, Matty V, what we're seeing there is a team, D-Ro, they're starting to put the gas pedal down right now. They're starting to get some length in this division.
Yeah, this team's playing well. They're playing with confidence. You can tell guys are walking to the plate with a swagger. Their pitchers are taking them out and executing pitches down and away. This is a good ball club.
Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. 1-2-3 go the Orioles. They're down 4-0. Now to the plate, Kevin Kiermaier. He'll be hoping to move up that American League leaderboard in this one as he enters play 9th in the league in home runs.
Yeah, he's blasted 4 home runs in his last 10 games, too. And he's got that power stroke working right now.
This guy's an absolute nightmare to opposing pitcher. Power to all fields, and he'll take that ball away and drive it for opposite field power.
Grounded weakly down the line toward third. But a foul ball, 1-1. And there's ball 2 now.
Yeah, he just isn't that sharp on the mound right now. Had a rough start in the first inning, and now he's falling behind out of the gate here in the second. Some adjustments need to be made, and fast.
The 2-1. Is swung on and missed for strike number 2.
You can't go after that pitch with less than 2 strikes on you. There's no way you're going to do any damage with a ball executed down and away in the zone.
Swing and a miss as he ran the fastball right by him for the first down.
That swing tells me he was really trying to get a pitch out front and rip it down the line, but that wasn't a great pitch to do it on. It's really not the best 2-strike approach either.
That brings up Wander Franco. As he will take strike 1 on the fastball here. No balls and a strike. 0-for-1 for him here in this one.
Nope.
Off the plate. 1 ball, 1 strike. Two and one to the Rays leadoff batter.
I don't blame him for not coming over the heart of the plate. He circled this guy on the lineup card when he got to the yard today. He's been swinging one of the hotter bats in the game.
Easy fly ball into shallow center field. And he will make the play out there, and there are 2 away now. Stepping in once again is Yandy Diaz. Worked a walk his first time up. Here it comes. As he'll take one up in the zone, but indeed in the strike zone for the first strike.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating and feeling really good about his fastball.
And we'll just leave it there as they make the play to end the inning. Down in order go the Rays, but they hold a 4-0 lead. So here's Trey Mancini, and they've got some work to do early on. Down 4-0 already.
They've gotten a gut punch to start this game. There's no doubt about this, but that's when you have to turn the scoreboards off. Everybody do their job, one at bat at a time.
Out in front here is this one scorched foul to the left. Into the windup, here comes the 0-2 pitch. Swung on, but it's pulled foul wide of third. Fastball called, strike three, and there's the first out of the inning. That'll bring in the versatile Pat Valaika, and he's a guy looking to break out in a big way. Hasn't been getting the results he or his club have been hoping for. He's ready. Here's the first pitch. Heading out towards shallow right. A Rosarena will come in a bit and put it away for the second out of the inning.
That is good.
Set to get his evening at the plate started. DJ Stewart trying to get it going at the plate. It's been tough sledding for him so far this year. Cut fastball in there for a called strike. Two out, nobody on. Got him to go after that one, and he's in a quick hold, 0-2.
Yeah, if he's going to pound the zone with this stuff all game, the offense better step up. Somebody's going to have to pull a trigger a little bit earlier in the count.
And that one yanked just foul. The windup and the 0-2 pitch. Not surprisingly here, this is on the ground to the right side. And the Orioles have their first hit of the ball game.
Hey, some guys look out there, Dan. They don't care. They can't execute the ball the other way. It's not that easy. They're going to hit it as hard as they can right into the chip and let the chips fall where they may.
You know, it's hard, D-Bro, when you've come up all the way through high school, little league, college ball, and the minor leagues, and you're used to pulling the ball. That's the type of hitter you are. Some of these hitters are going to have to try to make some changes with these exaggerated shifts.
2-0 now. Has a look. Now the pitch.
Whoa, that's up there.
Hey, struggling to find the release point of that curveball. That wasn't a very good one. Somehow he's just got to find that feel because that's a pitch he's going to need going forward.
And there's a strike as he'll try to work his way back. It's 3-1.
No, that's a foul ball.
3-2, two out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
Hard hit at third. Reined in. And he is in there. In a close play at first, but he's called out and his side is retired. So no runs on a hit here, no errors, one man left on. We play two full. The Rays are in front, 4-0. Striding in is Austin Meadows. He'll stand in to open things up here in the third. Infield in the overshift here, now the pitch. In there for strike one, 0-1.
0-1.
I guess the game plan from the offensive standpoint today coming into this one was they were going to work the counts. They've been super patient at the plate in the early goings of this game, and they've got the lead looking for more.
Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 0-2 pitch. Pitch taken several inches below the zone, in fact. And a fastball in the dirt that's taken for a ball.
Regardless of the result right here, to be down 0-2 and work it back to an even count, got to feel like it's a win for the offense.
Here's a fly ball, well hit. But it bangs off the out-of-town scoreboard. The relay, but it won't be in time, and it's a leadoff double.
Hey, after that base knock right there, he's into double digits, D-Ro. That's a 10-game hitting streak.
Oh, you talking about double digits, Dan? Now it's getting firm. We're seeing the batting average go up. We're seeing the homers go up. We're seeing the RBIs go up. Everything is moving north.
To the plate now, Brandon Lau.
Ball one.
A ball and no strikes. Another RBI spot for him. He's already got three in the game. Now the 1-0. A swing and a miss. That's the first strike. Meadows leads off second with nobody out. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. Has a look, now the pitch.
Ball, that's
misses, ball two.
I know he missed with a fastball right there, but this guy's arsenal, you can't figure out what he's trying to do. He's got a lot of different directions he could go in right here.
Pulled toward right center field. Catch made out there in right center as the runner will tag from second. The tag, and they got him at third. It's a double play.
Hey, I like to be aggressive on the base pass, put pressure on the defense, but you better be sure if you're tagging from second base that you're going to slide safely into third. He wasn't out by very much, but I don't care. You can't be giving up outs at third base.
In now, Randy Arozarena. And he'll take a changeup here for strike one. He launched one over the wall back in the opening frame. Not what he wanted to do there with the slider as it misses well above the zone. Keeping it down here as it's to one and two.
Hey, he's done an amazing job of settling down. 2 innings ago, I thought they were going to run him out of here. But now he's close to posting 2 shutout innings as a response.
Swung on in the dirt for the third strike. And that ends the inning. So no runs on 1 base hit, no errors, and no one left on. We'll move on to the bottom of inning number 3. The Rays are out in front, 4-0. At the plate now is Freddie Galvis. As we run you the numbers to see the splits between July and August. As he lifts it in the air to right field. Arozarena is in a few steps as he takes it for the first down. Digging in next, Pedro Severino. And he's a guy looking to break out in a big way. Hasn't been getting the results he or his club have been hoping for. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Meadows is there, so 2 pitches and 2 outs thus far.
Up next to Lloyd.
Next to hit is Jumai Jones. Bounced out last time up. Now pitch on the way.
The offense better get it going right here because they certainly can tell from their dugout. This guy is carrying himself with a presence out on the mound. He's got feel for all his pitches.
The windup and the 0-2 pitch. Here's a swing and a little tapper in front of the mound. And the inning is going to continue here as he reaches on an infield single.
Yeah, nobody on right there, Dan. 2 outs. It's not every day you see a guy pick him up and put him down like him getting down to first base right there. Bought himself a base hit.
Well, I'd say what if you do. There's a couple of things you can do. It doesn't take a lot of talent to hustle. It doesn't take talent to be on time. And he hustled out of the box, turned what could have been a ground out to end the inning into an infield single.
Austin Hayes is in with 2 away now as he looks at a called strike one.
That's a ball.
Can't find the zone there as he lays off the breaking ball.
That one looked like it could easily have gone the other way. There's a big difference between 0-2 and 1-1, but now this next pitch probably becomes the biggest of the at-bat.
And all that gets him on the mound. No chance to make a play. Let's see if he's okay out there. And with that play over now, time to check and see if our man is all right. You can really see him favoring that leg. And that is his plant leg, which is always a concern. But from the way he's acting out there, I think it looks like he's going to be okay to try and continue. So here is Ryan Mountcastle. 2 on, 2 out for him here in the third. And he takes a pitch that's ruled a strike at the knees. Pretty liberal strike zone there. It's 0-1. Hit high in the air down the right field line. Long run for the right fielder. And a long run, but he's there to track it down. Nice range, and the side is retired. Orioles strand a couple. They're on the short end of a 4-0 score. Welcome back to Baltimore as we send you down to check in with Heidi Watney.
Matt, Rays manager Kevin Cash talked to me in between innings about his lineup's offensive production. And flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats.
They've already put 4 runs on the board, and they've done so by running up their opponent's pitch count. So he said he thinks they're going to have a lot more opportunities to score because of that as the game goes on.
Good stuff, Heidi. Thanks. And that'll bring up the big stick of Nelson Cruz. We begin the top of the fourth.
Designated hitter, Nelson.
Now here's the pitch.
Count 1-0.
Well, it's been a rough one so far. 4 runs through 3 innings. It's about time to get that pitch count down, or he won't be out here very long.
Cruz awaits the 1-0. to short. Fielded by Galvis. Throw to first in time. One gone here in the fourth. Good time now to check out the Orioles Road to the Show report as you see a couple of guys in the upper levels that have been making waves of late. Here comes the Baltimore skipper out of the dugout on his way to the mound. And he's going to motion for his bullpen here. That'll do it for the starter tonight. So as he leaves, I would imagine these fans would not be much pleased with his performance here this evening. He certainly was not sharp. Cesar Valdez answers the call from the pen here in the fourth as they didn't get the outing they were hoping for from the starter. G-Man Choi the next to hit.
Outside,
as he'll take
a
look at a slider here that misses for ball one. He'll come in here at 259. 29 homers and 54 runs batted in. The 1-0. A swing and a miss, strike one.
Ball, one strike.
Both clubs with three hits in the ballgame. Very weakly on the ground. Now a swing and a ball foul tip straight into the catcher's glove as he's able to hold on for the second out. There's a look at the final line for the Orioles starter. And clearly he was off his game this evening.
Yeah, nothing seemed in sync for him out there in this one, Matt. He just couldn't get the ball where he wanted to. And the opponents really took advantage of that. That's a brutal feeling sitting in the dugout. Know that you disappointed your team and you went out there and laid an egg.
And there's a swing and a miss at an off-speed pitch to start him out. Nothing in one.
I can't speak from experience, but that's got to feel good right there. Throwing a nasty changeup first pitch and getting a swing and a miss on it. Now he pretty much opened up any pitch in his arsenal.
A pause and the 0-2. Right side and right into the shift. Scooped up. Throw to first beats him easily, and the side is retired. Rays go in order, 1-2-3, but they're in front, 4-0. So here's the cleanup hitter, Trey Mancini, who went down on strikes in his last at bat.
Yeah, always frustrating to go down looking. Everybody does it, though. You'll have a few ABs where you get completely fooled. Look for him to be on the attack early in the at bat.
0-1 the count. Oh, and he's really getting the better of him now. It's strike two.
This guy's been really on point so far, but it's not getting any easier. He has to get through 4, 5, and 6 right here.
Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. Another 0-2 coming. In the air, down the line in left. And foul. The next 0-2. Another foul ball, and this battle will continue. The 0-2 once more. Pops this one up. In there, a base hit.
Well, that's what's so disappointing as a pitcher, D-Lo. You make a really good pitch, and yet this guy's so big and so strong, he's able to muscle it into right field for a base hit.
Yeah, you hand your batting gloves to the first base coach right there, and you thank your lucky stars. That's a nice AB.
Into the box, Pat Valaika. And on the first pitch, he grounds foul. He's 0-for-1 thus far. A ball and a strike.
Hey, that backdoor breaking ball just missed. He had a chance to run it to 0-2.
High and deep down the left field line. And it's a foul ball. A ball and two strikes. Here's the pitch. A bouncer up the middle. One there. On to first to complete the double play.
Now batting. number 24.
So base is empty now after the double play. And digging in is the outfielder, DJ Stewart. As he'll look at a breaking ball that misses for ball one. Comes back with the cutter and gets it by him. One and one now. No runs, four hits, and no errors for the Orioles so far. And he misses two and one. Fouled off. Here now the 2-2. Hit to first. He's got it. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. One hit's all they get. We played four full. Tampa Bay leads this one 4-0. New inning set to get underway, and next will be a speed threat in the form of outfielder Kevin Kiermaier. Now the first pitch.
Nope, ball one.
And now a right-hander up and throwing in the Baltimore bullpen. Swing and a miss, one and one. Hit out towards second. Beautiful diving stop. Hats off to that one. So bases are empty with one out now. And here comes the five-tool middle infielder, Wander Franco. Ready to deal. Here comes the first pitch. Fastball just misses. That's ball one. And a sinker dips too low there. Into the dirt, in fact. Now a changeup is bounced to second. Reined in. Throw in time at first for out number two.
The third baseman.
Next, it'll be Yandy Diaz. He's set. Here it comes.
Nope. At the ball. Ball one, no strike.
One. Grounded back up the middle. And that's through for a hit.
Dan, that hit right there extends his hit streak to 8 games. Are you aware of stuff like that?
No doubt about it right now. He's swinging the bat really well. And after that knock right there, hey, listen, 8 games is nothing to sneeze at. So you can say, hey, he's going to hold calendar week.
There's a swing and a ball hit in the air, and a ball that he got every stitch of, as that one, without a doubt, is gone. So a two-run homer down the line in right field. 24 home runs for him on the season. As they pile on, it's now 6-0.
That's one of those pitches you wish you could take back as soon as it leaves your hand. But guess what? There are no delete or rewind buttons in baseball. That's a mistake, and it was a good job by his opponent to make him pay for it.
Stepping in now, Brandon Lau. And he fouls this one off. 1-for-2 in the ballgame thus far. As anticipated, here's a ground ball now to the right side. Over to first, and that retires the side. Rays get a couple as you take another look at the two-run home run. Halfway home tonight from Oriole Park. It's the Rays 6 and the Orioles nothing. Welcome back for the bottom of the fifth. Here's Heidi Watney.
Matt, I had a chance to discuss the state of the Orioles' offense with their manager between innings. And one thing he mentioned to me was the lack of discipline he's seeing out of their at-bats right now. He said they've been chasing at pitches out of the zone all game, which obviously doesn't usually lead to good results. Until they start being more selective with their swings, he said they will continue to struggle.
All right, Heidi, thank you. So stepping in is Rio Ruiz as we move past the halfway point in this one and begin the bottom of the fifth. As the first pitch to him is a changeup that can't find the zone. It's ball one. And he takes a called strike one.
I got one ball, one strike.
High in the air down the right field line. Long run for the right fielder, and he makes the catch in the corner.
The batter, number two.
Next to dig in, Freddie Galvis. He flew out in his last debut. Now the pitch. And he runs it in on him and gets him to swing through it for strike one.
Hey, it's a game of execution. If the pitcher stays right there, this lineup's going to continue to have a tough time.
And here's a curveball in the dirt that time for a ball. One and one.
We've seen this before. Fastballs in, then breaking balls away. That's been his plan of attack throughout the first half of this game.
That's popped up. But this'll land untouched.
I know that fastball registered at about 92, 93, but I guarantee you it looked about 4 to 5 miles an hour faster than that. For this offensive player, after coming off a curveball, the old push the throttle and pull it is being used.
Looked like the cut fastball there, and he got him to swing through it for the second out.
I'll tell you right now, this guy has a shutout going, and it's been all business. He's not messing around trying to pick at corners. He's being aggressive in the zone, and he's attacking each and every one of these hitters up to this point.
Pedro Severino digs in at the plate. Ball one to start the at-bat. Bases are empty here with two men out. That's wide, 2-0.
Hey, always a good idea to take a couple of pitches when you're facing a young arm like this one. And now he's put himself in a real good hitter's count.
Strike called, 2-1.
Ball three.
Curveball, and he thought it was strike two. Instead, it goes to 3-1.
Team's been struggling on offense. Let your D work for you right here. Pound the zone.
And a check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two. Hit on the ground to short. Fielded cleanly. Throw on to first. Gets him, and the side is retired. Three up, three down for the Orioles. They still find themselves down 6-0. Half of the sixth about to get started. from the stretch.
That's out.
Here's a changeup that's right there, 1-1. Swing and a miss, and it's a ball and two strikes here. Here comes the 1-2. Is swung on and missed. He got him.
Well, it's been a rough series for him at the plate so far. That's four strikeouts in the first two games, so this pitching staff clearly has him figured out.
At the plate, Nelson Cruz. He'll take a called strike here on a borderline pitch at strike one. He's 0-2 in the ballgame so far. That's in there, and he's deep in the hole now, 0-2.
Might have been taking all the way right there. That pitch couldn't have split the strike zone any better, and you can bet he wants that one back at the plate.
Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. And the slider gets him swinging, two gone. Next to hit, G-Man Choi. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate. He's set, and the pitch as he lays off a fastball too low for ball one. Hit back toward the mound. Galvis is there. Throw in time, and the side is retired. Down in order go the Rays, but they're on top by a count of 6-0. Leading off the inning, it'll be Jumai Jones.
Leading off for the Orioles, the second baseman, Jumai.
Wheels and deals, here's the first pitch. And a cut fastball in there for a strike, it's 0-1. Well below the knees, laid off on the changeup there. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Hit on the ground down the first baseline. But this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. Into the windup and the pitch. Line hard deep into left. Meadows has it, and there's one away.
Now back.
So with one gone, time for our look at the current standings. As you can see, these guys really have a comfortable lead in the division race to this point in the season. So next to bat will be Austin Hayes. A hit and two at-bats for him at this point in the ballgame. Ready to deliver. Here comes the first pitch. One out, nobody on. Down the third baseline. And this will stay inside the third base bag. A fair ball. He'll get it into second. The tag, and he's nabbed, trying for two.
The batter, number six, designated hitter, Ryan.
Now to bring up Ryan Mountcastle. As he'll take a good look at a curveball that sweeps right across the zone in there for the first strike. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. Out in front there as this one's pulled off to the left side. Hits are even right now at five aside. Softly hit out to short. And this will be pulled in easily for the final out of the inning. 1-2-3 go the Orioles. They won't make a dent in a 6-0 deficit. Digging in will be Francisco Mejia, 0-for-2 for him to this point.
The catcher, number 28, Francisco.
From the stretch, here's the pitch. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. Looks like a lefty and a right-hander throwing in the Baltimore bullpen. The 1-0 is swung on and missed. Strike one.
Ball two.
And now a fastball, but he's able to hold off on it, and it's 2-1 now. All even now, 2-2. A little late on the fastball, but he's able to spoil that one off, and he'll get another chance.
Well, somebody's sitting off speed right here. Only way he was late on that heater is he was expecting another changeup.
And this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's worked it full now at 3-2. Now the payoff pitch home. Down the first baseline. Nope. But this will get foul, so they'll do it again. 3-2. The payoff pitch one more time. Is a wave and a miss. He struck him out.
Yeah, as they say, there's a hole in his swing at that location. So a good job there of exploiting that. That can be real hard for some guys to overcome when teams start figuring out what locations you just can't handle.
Standing in, Kevin Kiermaier. He offers at it and sends a bouncer out to short. Galvis has to hurry.
Hey. Guys, let's take a look at the defense right here. Super, super quick on the exchange from glove to hand right there to even give himself a chance to get this fast base runner out. He beat it out, but he couldn't have done any more defensively on that play.
So now to the plate, Wander Franco, as he'll pop this one foul off to the left and out of play. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. The 0-1 pitch. Swing and a shot toward right center. But this will not get out there deep enough as it's run down by the right fielder in the alley for the second out.
Now batter, third baseman.
Up next for the Rays, Yandy Diaz. He's 1-for-2 in this one. First pitch on the way. Soft liner to the right side. And no problem over there at first as he flags this one down to end the inning. Rays strand just the one. They lead it 6-0. Shane McClanahan will come on out of the bullpen as he'll be appearing in his third game this season.
Shane McClanahan.
So now the Oriole cleanup hitter, Trey Mancini. He'll match up with a new pitcher to begin their half of the seventh.
Trey Mancini.
In tight here with the first pitch fastball that's 1-0. And he looks at a changeup in there, 1-1. McClanahan, a left-hander that stands 6'1" tall. This is his first year at the big league level. That's right there at the belt, 1-2 now. Swinging a ball hit on the ground. Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2. And a fastball swung on and missed as they set him down for the second time here tonight.
Now back.
Next, it'll be Pat Valaika. He was a double play victim last time around.
Yeah, rolling into a two ball will eat at you for the rest of the game at least. So you know he wants to make up for it right here.
That's the exact spot to lean on as a reliever. As a hitter, you just have to tip your cap and look for the next one.
Ball one, as the changeup misses well off the inside. Bases are empty, one man out. And they'll go off speed here as this pitch misses. It's 2-1. Could have been 3-1. Instead, it's 2-2.
That swing had one purpose, and that was to put the ball over the wall. I guess he doesn't have much to lose with his team down this many at this point in the game.
Full count now. Now the 3-2 pitch. Hit out towards second. And there are two away now. Stepping up is DJ Stewart, grounded out in his last at bat. Now the pitch. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Now a changeup, but it misses just a little below the zone.
I think when a team starts struggling, certainly offensively, it's just guys try and play above their pay grade. Know who the best players are in the lineup and try and get on base to set them up.
Two out, nobody on. 2-2. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Meadows makes the catch for out number three. Three up, three down for the Orioles. They still find themselves down 6-0. Tanner Scott comes on to pitch now, hoping for better results than the other arms that they've run out there in this one.
Number 66, Tanner Scott.
Now at the plate, here is Austin Meadows. He'll lead things off as they look to perhaps build on an already sizable lead. Here's the first pitch to him. In there, strike one. Off the plate, one ball, one strike. A little too much bite on the breaking ball that time as it's well off the outside. And he can't catch the corner here, so he's behind 3-1.
Well, this is the matchup they wanted bringing in the reliever, but falling behind 2-0 doesn't exactly help the situation very much.
3-1 takes a strike for a full count now. 3-2. Count remains full.
It's going to be back to some serious teamwork if he can't put that pitch in play right in his wheelhouse.
Oh, and he lets him off the hook there as this isn't even close for ball four.
Well, that was a slider in a 3-2 count, and it just didn't tempt him enough to get a good swing. A good job of pitch recognition and knowing the strike zone to draw the free pass there.
Ready now is Brandon Lau. His prior history in this matchup, he's 2-for-4. He comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. And that's in there for strike one. Meadows gets his lead at first, nobody out. This one's outside. Quite a bit off the plate that time. 1-2.
Looked like he was cheating a heater right there. A little bit too far out in front. Got to find a way to keep his hands back.
And a good bite to that slider as he swings through it for the first out of the inning. Good job of making him chase a pitch for the strikeout there.
Yeah, Matt, that's the advantage of getting ahead in the count. You can really force hitters to expand their zone to protect. And when they're in that mode, getting them to go after a pitch they can't do much with becomes a lot easier.
At the plate now, Randy Arozarena, as he'll go after the first pitch and bounce it into foul territory. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. Here's the 0-1.
Aye. Ball.
Man, that's a good take there on that 0-2 fastball just missed. He must have a really good eye at the plate.
And he gets him to pop it up on the right side of the infield. Jones camps under it, and he's got it for out number two.
Now batter, designated hitter.
So next to hit is Nelson Cruz, 0 for 3 with a couple of strikeouts for him to this point in the ballgame. He's set. Here it comes. As he takes a cold strike at the knees, it's 0-1.
You can really tell they're trying to keep the ball in on this big slugger right here.
Is that an effort to keep him from getting extended, do you think?
Yeah, I think that's the idea, Matt. But he might spin to win if he starts looking for it in there.
And the slider is low and inside as he just about got him there. Can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2. And we're going to have a quick stoppage here as a beach ball has made its way into right field. A ball and two strikes. Here's the pitch.
No, that's low.
6 runs, 6 hits, and no errors for Tampa Bay so far. Inside with the slider, and that'll back him up a bit.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
He's set. Here's the 3-2. A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. And that one is gone on a 2-strike count with 2 away in the inning. A 2-run dinger off the bat of Nelson Cruz, number 449 now for his career, as they've widened this lead to 8 now.
As a hitter, that feels so good. The previous pitch ran in on him, trying to get him off the plate, but the next pitch, he mashes it out of here. Goes to show you can't intimidate him.
And now, G-Man Choi, as he will take a fastball in there at the knees for strike one. Lifetime versus this pitcher, he's 1 for 5. Set to deliver the 0-1. Swing and a miss on the slider, and he's quickly behind, nothing and two.
The count doesn't mean much to this batter. He's all in. He's not concerned with striking out, so he's going to get his A swing off.
Protecting on 0-2, so we'll do it again.
You can definitely tell with that foul off right there that he's picking up spin on this pitcher's off-speed stuff. Maybe expect a fastball on this next one.
Got him swinging as he runs the fastball by him to end the inning. But two come across to score in the inning courtesy of this 2-run home run. Bottom of the 8th coming up. It's the Rays 8 and the Orioles nothing. Bottom of the inning now, and set to go is the third baseman. Rio.
The third baseman.
V. Vidal Bruján will come on defensively now as he takes over at second.
Now playing second. Number seven, Vidal.
First offering on its way.
Ball one, no strike.
One and one, here it comes.
And it's one and two.
One ball, two.
Wow, great pitch right there, right? Changing speeds. How about that straight changeup? How about that swing? Howdy, if you're waving at me.
Fouled away. And we're going to have a quick stoppage here as a beach ball has made its way into right field. Yanked on the ground down the line. But this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at one and two. Into the windup and the pitch. And a changeup swung on and missed for the first down.
He put up a pretty good battle at the plate right there. They finally get him on a one and two pitch,
the
but
batter,
you could see
two.
That he wasn't laying Shuts down without up. A fight. He
Ready.
Really made the pitcher earn that strikeout.
Galvin.
To the plate now, Freddie Galvis. Standing in from the right side as he takes strike one. No hits to this point. And this is taken. It's a ball and a strike now to the Baltimore shortstop. Snatched out of midair at first base for out number two.
Now batting, catcher, Pedro.
Next to stand in is Pedro Severino. He's 0 for 2 thus far in this one. Oh, and this is hit high and deep out to left. And, oh, he missed a home run by a matter of feet. It's off the wall. And the gamble will work out. He's in at second base with a two-out double.
Up next for the Orioles.
It's not exactly Fenway Park out there in left field, but a ball off the wall is not a gimme double here either. So even though he almost drove it out of the ballpark, it was well played off the carom. They got it in quickly, and he might consider himself lucky to beat that throw into second base.
Jumai Jones is in with two away as he takes a ball 1-0. Called strike at the knees, 1-1. Fly ball out toward left center field. Kiermaier's got a read on it, and that retires the side. So they can't make anything out of the two-out double. More from the show, Saturday Baseball, following this message and a word from our local stations. Set to start the ninth in this one, and now it'll be the catcher, Francisco Mejia.
Number 28, Francisco Mejia.
First pitch of the AB on its way.
All ones the count. Ball, that's out. Two balls, one strike.
The 2-1 pitch. Lifted in the air toward the line and right, but this is just going to wind up being a foul ball. Hit in the air down the right field line. Valaika has to come in a few steps, but he has it for out number one.
Up next is Tampa Bay.
Now it'll be Kevin Kiermaier in his. Brett Phillips steps into the on deck circle now, looking to start something here with one gone in the inning.
Brett Phillips.
Here's the first pitch to him.
Yeah.
We'll check in with an average still south of 230. 10 home runs and an even 20 RBIs. The 0-1 pitch.
Yeah, you could tell he was ready for another fastball, but the pitcher went to breaking ball, and the hitter just fouls that one off.
And a swing and a miss here, and the first two are dispatched to begin the ninth.
It's so hard to hit when you're behind the count 0-2, right? You have to protect for the fastball. You have to look for the soft stuff down and away. You're really at a disadvantage when you fall behind 0-2.
Standing in now, Wander Franco. He'll take a look at ball one. Struggling so far in this one and looking to erase his 0-for-4 ball game right here. The 1-0. Now a swing and a fly ball. But this is going to wind up a foul ball. The 1-1. Line drive to center field, but this will not get down quickly enough as it's pulled in out there in center, and that ends the inning. Nothing doing here this half. 2, 3, and 4 set to kick off the bottom of the ninth. The Rays lead it 8-0. Brett Phillips is the new center fielder after coming on as a pinch hitter during the last half inning.
Now playing center field.
Austin Hayes the next to bat. He's going to lead things off in their half of the ninth as they try to avoid the dreaded shutout.
It's never a good feeling to get shut out, and over the course of the season, it's bound to happen a few times. They've just been overmatched by good pitching.
As it's grounded sharply to first, and they'll take it to the bag himself for the out. Up next, Ryan Mountcastle. No hits in 3 tries so far. He struck out once. Now here's the first offering. One out, nobody on. Barely able to make contact. Down 0-2 now. And it's fouled away. Hit down the third baseline. A diving try, but he can't haul it in. It's through for a base hit.
Hey, that's a heck of an effort by the third baseman right there, selling out to try and save extra bases for the pitcher, but it got through.
And here's the big right-handed power threat, Trey Mancini. Strike one to start the at-bat. Lifted down the line and left. And this will wind up a foul ball. Ready on 0-2. Lofted in the air out toward right center. A Rosarena is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first. Stepping in next, Pat Valaika, who was retired via the ground ball last time up. Ready to deliver, here comes the first pitch, as he will take strike one on the fastball here. No balls and a strike. Now a good pitch around the knees, but it doesn't quite catch the bottom of the zone. 1-1, and this will be a called strike two, and trouble now as they're down to their final strike tonight. Swing and a miss. He struck him out, and that'll do it here as the ball game is over.
Well, just an excellent job right here closing this one out. He just collected the first save of his career. Got to start somewhere.
An 8-0 shutout this evening. The Tampa Bay Rays get the win on the heels of 4 home runs. Brendan McKay gets to double digits with his 10th win of the year. Bruce Zimmerman couldn't escape the 4th inning as he slapped with the loss. Shane McClanahan takes the rare 3-inning save, his first of the year. So that's a wrap here tonight. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and Heidi Watney, this is Matt Vaskirjan. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, find us on Twitter, at MLB The Show. No time for that, he say. I care about what she say. Self-care like he pray. Give thanks before I eat pray. But tell a hater that I eat pray. I'm like Miami where the heat said. Now I'm riding up the 2-2. You would think I'm in the 6.
6'6". Born June 26, 36, but I never the brick. When I shoot, I never break. When I shoot, it swish. Fourth quarter, 10 on the clock.
The final line score for our ball game tonight for the victorious Reds.